ஓம் சாந்தி. 11th of August, இங்கிலீஷ் முரளி. எசன்ஸ், ஸ்வீட் சில்ட்ரன் ஓன்லி பை ஹேவிங் அன்அடல்டரேட்டட் ரிமெம்பரன்ஸ் வில் யுவர் ஸ்டேஜ் பிகம் அன்ஷேக்கபிள் அண்ட் இம்மூவபிள். மேக் சச் எஃபர்ட் தட் யூ ரிமெம்பர் நத்திங் பட் த ஒன் ஃபாதர். க்வெஸ்சன், வாட் சர்வீஸ் டஸ் யூ பாபா டூ and what is that you children have to do? Answer: at the confluence edge, Shubaba removes all souls from the graveyard, that is, he does the service of purifying souls who, having come into body consciousness, have become impure. You children have to become lighthouses and, along with the father, show everyone the way to the land of peace and the land of happiness. Let there be liberation in one eye and liberation in life in the other. Song: who created this play and then did himself away? Om Shanti. In fact, this song belongs to the path of devotion. There is definitely someone this prize belongs to. The children understand very clearly that it is the father who does everything. He is Karan Karavanhar. Sick people sing his praise a great deal because their religion is new, whereas that religion is very old. They remember Ek Omkar, God is one, an oval image. Baba has also explained the meaning of Om very clearly, whereas they give a very long and complicated explanation. I tell you that the Supreme Soul, I am the resident of the Supreme Abode. I do not take rebirth. You take rebirth. The father sits here and introduces himself to the children. I reveal myself to only you children. It has been explained to you that I am the Supreme Father, the Supreme Soul, the one you souls have been remembering on the path of devotion as God, the Father. He is praised as the purifier, the merciful one and the liberator. He is also called the guide. This is the Pandav army. The guide shows the path to liberation and liberation in life. People sing, take our boat across. God is definitely called the boatman as well as the master of the garden. He says, you used to be very intoxicated. You were carefree emperor in the golden and silver ages. You had so many riches. At Srinathdware, they cook rich food for the bhog they offer. They cook very rich, nourishing food there, whereas they only cook rice and dal at the Jagannath temple. Dirty images of deities are displayed there. All of you were now dirty. At the Srinathdware temple, they make first class food, which they offer to Srinath as bhog. It is then taken by priests who sell it at their stalls. They earn their livelihood through that. You children are becoming the masters of heaven. Your maids and servants also eat the same rich food that you eat there. 36 varieties of food are prepared, but you are couldn't eat that much, and so the maids and servants eat it as well. However, you mustn't simply be content with that. A whole kingdom is being created. You will live there in great pleasure and comfort. You children receive your fortune of the kingdom of heaven that is established by the world almighty authority. It is said, knowledge, devotion and disinterest. Now, there are two types of disinterest. The disinterest of sannyasis is limited. They leave their homes and businesses and go and live in the jungles. They help to bring a lot of benefit to Bharat in an incognito way. It is said that the gates of heaven open through destruction. In the same way, sannyasis help through their purity. This is why their price is sang in the drama. The father says, this knowledge will later disappear. So, their disinterest is limited, whereas your is unlimited. The unlimited father inspires you to have unlimited disinterest. Stay in your households and simply remove everything from your intellects. These are old bodies. Your 84 births are now complete. Forget your bodies and all your bodily religions and relationships and consider yourself to be souls. They say that souls are immune to the effort of action, that you can eat and drink whatever you want and you will not be affected in any way. There are many different opinions and many different systems and costumes. Whatever idea someone starts, it just carries on. For instance, some refer to Adidev as Mahavir, but then they also call Hanuman Mahavir. In fact, all of you are Mahaviras, great warriors who gain victory over Maya. You make effort based on Srimat. You have to create a stage like that of Angad, whom Ravan wasn't able to shake. No matter how many storms of Maya come, you great warriors must not shake. You cannot have this stage at this time, but it will be like that at the end. No matter how many storms of vicious thoughts come, you must remain unshakable. You should have unadulterated remembrance. No one else should be remembered. A great deal of effort is required for this. Only at the end will you be completely unshakable and immovable. There is a memorial of Achalgar, home of the unshakable one, above, that is Guru Shikhar. You now understand that Shubhabha is the highest on high. He is the creator. What does he create first? This too should remain in your intellects. Shubhabha is the highest on high. Then there are Brahma, Vishnu and Shankar, the residents of the settled region. Why is Vishnu shown with four arms? This is the proof of the household path they follow. Your path is the household path. Establishment takes place through Brahma. The Brahmin religion is the highest of all. You are even more elevated than the deities because you do service. You carry out the establishment of the deity religion and you then become the masters of the world. The one father is the greatest of all, that is only Shubhabha, and no one else is worthy of praise. The principal birthday is Shubhabha's, because no one else does as much service. Lakshmi and Narayan just experience their reward. It is now the time of settlement for everyone. Initially, it is the father who is worshipped. That worship is unadulterated. Worship has now become completely adulterated. Starting with Shubhabha, you know everyone's occupation. You are now sitting with Baba in practice. You understand that you are once again making Bharat into heaven. Those who create it will then go and rule there. There will be the dynasty of Lakshmi and Narayan and then that of Rama. Now, what benefit is there in worshipping them? They have to descend. They simply experienced their reward. That's all. You are now becoming worthy of worship from worshippers. Where is Ganesh with a trunk and Hanuman with a tail and the goddesses with 8 to 10 arms? All of that is the explanation of the path of devotion. You understand what happens on the path of devotion and how you take 64 births. you are now Brahmins. Then from Brahmins, you go through the deity, warriors, merchants and Shudras, castes. This drama is externally fixed. No one can stop it. This is a game of somersaulting. People go on a pilgrimage while somersaulting. Previously, the game of somersaulting while on a pilgrimage was considered very important. Now, so many different opinions have emerged. No one expects the One Father can grant liberation or liberation in life. You now have liberation in one eye and liberation in life in the other. Your intellects say, we are lighthouses. You are the lighthouses who show human beings the path. First of all, you have to return to your sweet home. This play is now about to end. You children understand that this true Gita is being created so that those who are weak can study and become strong. Everything else is to be destroyed. The same Gita will be created again. They quote a verse from the Gita and then explain the meaning of it. It says in the Gita, God speaks. It was God who speak the Gita, but people don't understand that. The Father says, I cannot be found by studying those scriptures. I come when devotion ends. Knowledge is the day and devotion is the night. For half a cycle, it is the kingdom of Ravan. Ravan is not visible. It can be understood with the intellect. When someone has the evil spirit of lust and someone has the evil spirit of anger, these words of impurity are not used in the golden age. Here people continue to insult one another. None of these things exist in the golden age. You now understand that the Father, the purifier, is the creator of heaven. He creates heaven and then hides himself away. No one is able to know him. Even though there is the image of Shiva, people don't understand anything about when or how Shubhabha come. What the significations of Brahma, Vishnu and Shankar is or where they reside. How did Lakshmi and Narayan claim such an elevated kingdom in heaven? They do not exist in the Iron Age. You now understand how they climbed the kingdom. You children have to study very well with the Father, then teach others. The Father says to all his children, my long lost and now found children, O my Saligrams, I enter this body in order to explain to you. I have adopted this body of Brahma. Brahmins are created through Brahma. People don't object when you go to other satsangs, but they do object when you come here. Quarrels takes place due to poison. This is about this that the Father says. This poison causes you sorrow from its beginning through the middle to the end. This is the number one enemy. Conquer this enemy of lust, the enemy that has caused you sorrow from its beginning through the middle to the end. This is why people call out, O purifier, come. They know that they are impure. That is why they go and bow their heads in front of pure ones. Sannyasis attracts others with their purity. And this is why they are given a high status. They also think that no one throughout the whole world of Bharat is as elevated as they are. You Shaktis also shot the arrows at them. If it had been a question of physical arrows, it would not have been said that it was God who inspired them to shoot those arrows. Those arrows are knowledge. You are Brahma Kumaris, but they call you Brahma Kumaris. they say that Brahm, element of light, is God. The father says that is their Brahm, imagination. Many sannyasis now come to you. Many eminent people also go to the sannyasis. They say, Mahatmaji, come. We will offer you food. They offer them very good hospitality. They are a symbol of purity. Nowadays, many robbers dresses up as sannyasis. You are completely honest. And you are also Raj Rishis. You now understand everything from the top to the bottom. You understand that you will become deities like Lakshmi and Narayan and claim your reward. Halfway through the cycle, when other religions come, wars begin. All of that is fixed in the drama. You have become knowledgeful. Having come to know the supreme religion, the subtle region, and the physical world, and the beginning, the middle, and the end of the world, you also understand the cycle in order to become rulers of the globe. Lakshmi and Narayan were the king and queen with a double crown in Bharat. Those with a single crown bow down to them. They had the power of purity. In the golden age, they were completely voiceless. People sing, you are completely voiceless, full of all divine virtues. Why do they sing this praise? Because they themselves are Vaishyas worshippers. The whole play rests in Bharat. There was a double crown and then a single crown. And now there is no crown. You have come to understand the whole world cycle. You now understand who the creator, the director, and the principal actor is. You will then become deities. The dirt of Maya is being washed off you. The father says, I am the laundry man and also the greatest goldsmith. Your ornaments are now put in a furnace. You will then become real ornaments. The father is also the barrister who releases you from the jail of the five vices. He liberates you. You are in the jail of Ravan. Baba gives you legal advice on how you can free yourself from this jail. The father says, I carry out my task, give you the fortune of the kingdom, and then I disappear. You become happy. Once you have claimed your kingdom, I will go into retirement. Acha. Who are the most fortunate ones? Baba says, the Kumaris are the most fortunate. Baba says, I fulfill my duty. You are impure and unhappy, and you cry out. Therefore, the father's duty is to grant the children liberation and liberation in life. There is no one else who can grant liberation. Those people give themselves many titles, but they are all completely wrong. The intellects of human beings are completely without love and the time of destruction. You children continue to say Baba, Baba. However, people don't understand the significance of this. They think that you are perhaps remembering this Baba, Brahma Baba. You children know that Baba has made you into the masters of heaven innumerable times. This is your godly birth. The father says, remember me alone. It is that requires effort. Acha. To the sweetest beloved, long lost and now found children, love, remembrance and good morning from the mother, the father, Bap Dada. The spiritual father says namaste to the spiritual children. The spiritual children says namaste to the spiritual father. Essence for Dharana. First point, study well with the father and teach others. Become a lighthouse and show everyone the path to liberation and liberation in life. Second point, stay in unadulterated remembrance of the one father and thereby create an unshakable and immovable stage for yourself. Become a great warrior. Blessing. may you be a conqueror of master and remain beyond any influence of the upheaval of master by staying in a high stage. You are becoming conquerors of Maya, but you now also have to become conquerors of masters, because there is now going to be a lot of upheaval of master. Sometimes the water of the ocean will show its influence, and sometimes the earth will show its influence. If you are a conqueror of matter, none of the upheaval of matter will be able to shake you. You will always be a detached observer and observe all the games. Just as angels are always shown on a high mountain, similarly, you angels have to stay constantly in a high stage. And the higher you are, the more you will automatically remain beyond any upheaval. Slogan: to give all souls the experience of cooperation with your elevated vibrations is tapasya. Acha Om Shanti.